Hello, this is Katie with a quick overview of Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. In your Blackboard Learn course, you'll notice under Tools, we still have access to Blackboard Collaborate Original, but we also can choose to use Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. As always, I recommend to make it easier for students to create a tool link by clicking on the plus at the very top left of your Blackboard Learn course and choosing Tool Link. For the type, choose Blackboard Collaborate Ultra, and you can name it whatever you'd like and make it available to users. That just makes it easier for students to join. When I click that link, you're going to see right away one of the advantages of Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. There's a session created for you already. And if you click on it, you can look on the far right of your screen, and there are some options you may want to change. Most of them are pretty simple and intuitive. Here's another new feature. There's now three roles, not just participant, which is typically students, and moderator, which is typically faculty. There's a middle role called presenter, which works well for guests and also student presenters. And looking through these options, this is another feature that's a little different. Previously, profile pictures would only show for moderators. That's not the default anymore, which is good. And you can take a look through some of these other options, and then you can save any changes that you've made. In order to join this session, you and your students will click on Session Options and Join Course Room. You may want to create sessions in addition to this if you wanted student work groups or something like that that were for a specific purpose. But this room is nice because it's unlocked. Students can join it even without you, and it's open all the time. I'm going to go ahead and join the course room, and you can see right away that it doesn't require a download or install. It just opens up in a new tab, and that's really nice. So I'm going to join from a browser because I'm on my computer. But the Blackboard Student app and the Blackboard Instructor app are other mobile options for joining a Collaborate session. If you are using a guest link, it will prompt you here to enter your name. But since I'm in a course, it knows who I am already. And it takes a moment for the room to open, and I'm the only one in the room, so it's empty right now. This has a video focus, so what I would normally be seeing in this area would be thumbnail webcams of other participants. On the far left side is the Open Session menu. At the top, when I click, probably the most important thing to find there is the recording. If I click Start Recording, you'll notice a little picture of a video camera with red in it that allows me to know that it is recording this session. Next, I want to explain the buttons across the bottom. The first button is my profile picture. I'll show you how to change that in a moment. And it has a lot of important things on it. My away button, leave the session, all of my emoticons, and then also my quick agree, disagree, green check, red X. And when I choose one of these things, it indicates it not only right here for me. I'm going to click on the bottom right purple icon and look at the attendee panel. Anybody who's looking at the attendee panel will also see my smiley face next to my name. Going back to the bottom center, the microphone is a little slow to open, I've noticed, but now that it's on, you can see that it's working fine because it's moving as I'm talking. Also, I can share my video. And so now there's my video, and normally I would be seeing multiple videos from other people in the session, up to four, depending on your browser at this point, but Blackboard is working on making it so that you can see more videos at a time. I'm going to go ahead and turn both of those off for now. And the fourth button across the bottom is the raise hand button. Once again, I can see the indicator both myself at the bottom of my screen that I have my hand raised, but anybody looking at the attendee panel will also see an indication that my hand is raised. So a review of the bottom, I have my status, I have my microphone, I have my webcam, and then I have my raise hand button. Now, on the far right is where the moderator is going to be doing most of their work. So at the bottom right, you see the collaborate icon, the purple icon, and that expands it. And across the bottom, you have your chat, your attendee panel, share content, and settings. So I'm going to start with settings. This is where you would change your profile picture. This is where you can set up your camera and microphone. And if you scroll down, there's some other settings you might want to look at, including notifications and session settings. So settings looks like the typical settings wheel. Going back to the attendee panel, which is the second option, you might be used to seeing the attendee panel all the time, and you can do that in Blackboard Collaborate Ultra by clicking the three buttons at the top right, detaching the panel. Now, for example, I can see my attendee panel and my chat at the same time. And chat works like it always has. And there's also emoticons that you can add. You just have to be a little careful. If you were to go back a screen, you'd see there's a separate chat for everyone than there is just for moderators. So you want to make sure you're paying attention by looking at the word at the top. And probably what moderators are going to want to know the most about is sharing content. So you can share a blank whiteboard. And because this attendee panel is now in my way, I'm going to click the three dots in the top right and merge the panel back. And now it's appearing down at the bottom right again. So the blank whiteboard, you can see that I am sharing it. There are some buttons at the top. They really are very easy to use. And you can move things around a little bit, as well as make them bigger. And the pencil is very useful as well. The only problem is there's no way to make additional pages. There's simply this one. And as soon as I go somewhere else, like let's say I want to look at application sharing or share files, then when I go to one of the files that I've uploaded, for example, when I click add files, I can load PowerPoint files. I can load PDF files now, so that's a nice improvement. And I can also load images as before. So for example, I'm just going to click on one of these to share. And let's say I'm sharing this student rights PDF with the students. And now if I go back and click back on my whiteboard, everything I drew on there or wrote on there is gone. So you do have to just be careful that if you're having students brainstorm or create content on the whiteboard, whether it's in the main room or the breakout groups, you have to take a screenshot in order to save that information. There's no other way at this time to do that, but they are working on it. So there's a stop button that looks like a white square in the top right-hand corner. So no matter what content I'm sharing, I can always hit the stop button and it'll go back to that video screen where I'm seeing thumbnails of everybody else in the class who has their webcam turned on. So going back to share files, these stay. So anything you've uploaded will stay, and you have to manually click the trash button to get rid of them. Next time I come in for my class next week, these same ones will be here. And it takes a while if it's a 70-page PDF, for example, for it to load. It takes a little bit more clicking. So if I click on this PowerPoint, I have to click Share Me, or Share Now, excuse me. And then I can click on whichever one of the slides I want to share. And then notice at the bottom, I've got the arrows where I can move through the slides to show the students. And while I can use a pointer tool, I find it to be really small and difficult to see, as well as slow to react. So I end up using the pencil tool, and I usually pick a bright color. And then I indicate what I'm talking about by just using the pencil tool. And so just to demonstrate what I've said before, markup disappears as soon as you navigate away from it. So if I click on the next slide and then go back to the previous slide, that markup is gone. Something to keep in mind. So I can hit the stop button in the top right-hand corner to stop sharing. Next, I want to show you application sharing. It is improved somewhat. I can share my entire screen or just an application. In this example, I'll just pretend I want to share my syllabus with students. So I can scroll through an application share Microsoft Word. And then I can either minimize it or just click on collaborate in the background to stop sharing with the stop button in the right hand corner. And I guess I should put my hand down. So the polling has improved. There are some additional features besides the green check and red X, which I showed you before. You can create polls with multiple choices. Also, breakout groups work pretty well. The only problem, again, is content, with the whole whiteboard situation being the way it is. It's not easy for students to write on the whiteboard and then share it back to the main room. So this is where the content is. And just to recap, at the bottom right, we have our chat, we have our attendee panel, which can be detached, we have share content, and then we also have our settings. And to collapse that panel, we can click the X. While Blackboard Collaborate Ultra looks completely different from original, it does have some improvements in audio, video, polling, application sharing, the additional role that I mentioned of presenter. The limitations include no timer, nothing can be pasted onto the whiteboard, you still can't watch videos together, and breakout rooms are a little bit clunky. Recordings don't include chat or participant lists. So those are just some differences we'll have to get used to. But Blackboard is working on improving a lot of the features, and they are listening to our requests.